evening, everyone, and welcome once again to our sing-along. And I trust if you've received the words that you printed them out and you've got a copy of them in front of you so that you can sing along with us. This is a great old hymn. I think I only heard it about maybe 15 years ago for the first time myself, but it's got tremendous meaning and great doctrine in it. It says, "How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure." Just imagine the love of God, so great, that he would reach down and save us, and we become his treasure. That's some treasure, isn't it, when you think of our own lives? How deep the Father's love for me.
How great the pain of searing love.
Thankful that he came and took away our sin and our shame and our guilt, bore it all upon himself, gave to us new life. So glad you joined us this evening. Sonia, who's listening in this evening, and what comments would you have there?
Yeah, Francis Jackson said hi.
Hi, Francis.
And Don Naskerville said, great song and sung so beautifully. And Sharon, Carol, Donna, Lillian.
Oh, hi, Lillian.
And Linda Mick, Sandy Patterson, Judy Antoinette, wow. Ruth Halsden.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's quite a list already. So glad that so many of you have joined us this evening. If you want to just take your finger and push that like button, as many of you have done, or you can push a comment button and leave some word, tell us where you're from. And then the third thing there is to share. So if you know somebody else that might enjoy these old hymns, you could just sort of give them that favor of hearing some of the great old gospel songs. This is one again that just simply says, Kneel at the Cross. This time we're going to say just the first one. Is that okay? That the first one and name it.
Mm-hmm.
Lord of All, or Ross Anderson, All Hail the Power. So it depends on what you will accept there.
I can go with the real title.
I know, so then I guess All Hail the Power of Ross Anderson.
All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. Amen. That's the right title, but the words, Linda, that you gave there are correct as well. So, Ross, if you'd private message me and just email me and send me your address, and we'll send you out a booklet or two that we've written over the last few years. I'm just in the process of compiling a booklet right now. I'm up to about, I think it's about 78 pages. I'm going to stop at around 100 or so. But we're compiling another booklet of things that we've written about on many, many different subjects over the last several years. So hopefully we're going to have that ready in another couple of months, and we'll be able to get a copy for you there. Another great old song. This one says, "Will Your Anchor Hold?" I think we talked about it before, about the nautical themes that many songs have, and that's like a boat out on the ocean being tossed and turned. And one of the good things about a boat is that they can throw it an anchor. Even the large ships have huge anchors go down by electric motors, but the small boats have an anchor. When we used to go fishing, Dad would say, we're gonna stop at this point here. So he'd go out that way about another 30 feet, we'd throw the anchor in, and then we'd coast back, drift back over it, and when we finally found the anchor gripping, then we'd tie the anchor off, and the boat would stay firm. Well, that's what's missing in our society right now. That is that we really do need a solid anchor. And this song says, "Will your anchor hold in the storms of life?" Now, a lot of times when we used to play and do the song, we used to have people singing with us, right alongside us. So I could drop out at any time I wanted. And you notice I do that when I want to concentrate on playing. So what I want you to do is I want you to sing real loud. If you hear me dropping out, you sing loud. How's that? And we may not hear you, but you'll know you're covering in for us. How's your anchor this evening? Is it really holding?
Sure, well, the
anchor, and as long as it holds, we can't fail. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I guess probably the second or third best loved Christian hymn that there is.
Thank you.
not even in the same key or the same song, but he began to sing this little chorus, brought it back to my memory.
The greatest thing in all my life is knowing you. The greatest thing in all my life is knowing you. I want to know you more. I want to know you more.
Heavenly Father, once again, we thank you for the opportunity of coming into the homes of so many folk that really do need Jesus. I pray, Lord, that you would come against all fear that there might be in the hearts of many. Because perfect love casts out fear, so Father, let fear be broken in their lives. Precious faith that comes from God our Father, may that come into their hearts as well. Father, we just thank you for those that have served you. Thank you, Lord, for that one brother that was with us a couple weeks ago. He's paid such a high price to serve you, Lord. No wonder he says the greatest thing in all of his life is serving. Touch him this evening, wherever he may be, he and his wife. I pray, Lord, as well for those that are ill, that the healing touch, the flow of the Holy Spirit will come into their life, that the power of the risen, resurrected Lord, the healing Savior, will be their power that delivers them from their sickness. If there's any, Lord, that are watching that do not know you as Savior, and they have very little hope in their lives, I pray, Father, tonight will be the night that they would invite Jesus in to be the personal Lord and Savior. Thank you, Father, you're still on the throne.
Thank you.
King of Kings. Hallelujah. God bless you. We'll see you again next week, Lord willing. Amen. Bye now.